Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. As promised, this video is about the second and third function that has been released in Excel recently, PIVOTBY and PERCENTOF. I hope you have watched the first part of this video, which was about GROUPBY, also released in November, along with these two functions. So let's see what these two functions are about. We start with PIVOTBY. If you have checked GROUPBY, this one is pretty similar to that, but it also has column fields as argument. Let's take a look at the syntax. All of these arguments are the same as in GROUPBY, except we now have arguments related to column as well. In PIVOTBY, we have to choose column fields, their total depth, which is whether we want the subtotals and grand totals, and their sort order too. Rest of all the arguments are same as before, so let's move on to our example. This time, I have changed our dataset a bit. We have the same clients and their city, country, and region, but instead of just revenue and profit, I have their revenue from the last 6 months. I thought this might be a better example when talking about something related to a pivot table. Back to our dataset, I have already created a simple pivot table which shows sum of revenue from all the regions. We'll start by recreating the same result as in this pivot table with our pivot by formula. So let's start by writing a formula here. PIVOTBY, we need the region in our rows, so we select the region from the header to the end. Next up is column fields, but we don't have any in our pivot, so we'll skip that for now. Function is sum, and we want the field headers, so we choose this option and finish our formula. And here we have the same result as our pivot table. Let's compare both of them. No doubt the numbers are the same, but what I like about a pivot table is the automatic formatting you get. The headers and the totals are bold, which is good. And that's about it. Our PIVOTBY results, though they don't have that automatic formatting, but they have the headers clearly marked. Like our region column clearly says region instead of row labels. Our totals say the name of the month instead of adding sum of at the beginning of each column header. It could be just me, but I think this is a better format to be used for a report or a presentation. But to each his own, you may prefer the pivot table type layout, and I believe that's because we have been using pivot tables for so long that we are accustomed to it. But apart from the looks, there's one thing that sets them apart, or rather kills the pivot tables when it comes to functionality. Keep a close look on the figures of Asia in our pivot table and our pivot by results. If I am to change the figures of Singapore City here, which is in Asia, like if I am to delete it, our pivot table figure is unchanged, but our pivot by results are updated instantly. In order to update our pivot table, we have to right-click on it and click refresh. This, according to me, is a killer feature in itself. Next major difference is the number of aggregate options available in both. While pivot table has these options available to aggregate your data, but pivot by again wins here as it has more options available to us. In essence, PIVOTBY has all the options from pivot table and some more. Like we don't have percent of, median, array to text, concat, and more in pivot table, but we do in PIVOTBY. So, PIVOTBY wins here as well, hands down. In all fairness though, I must mention, while in pivot table, you have the ability to individually change these options for each column. For instance, let's say we want the average in case of June instead of sum. So we go in the values box and click on sum of June, go to value field settings and choose average from here. Hit OK and we have average for only the month of June. Rest all the months are still on sum. Coming to our pivot by results, the function argument which has all the aggregate options is kind of a blanket deal. If I am to change this to average, it changes it for all the months. So I guess depending on your situation, you can choose your winner in this category. Now let's get back to our arguments in our PIVOTBY formula. We had skipped on adding column fields, so let's start with those first. So first let's drag the country name to our column box in pivot table, and now let's recreate this in our PIVOTBY formula. So we edit our formula and go to the column fields argument and select our country name column to our formula like this, and done. I really don't like this type of layout. It goes so far horizontally that just trying to analyze the data making heads and tails of it becomes a huge task. But I just wanted to show you guys the use of column fields argument. So that's one job done, and now let's make this data a bit better by dragging our country name to our rows box, like this, and this makes it a lot better. Now let's do the same to our PIVOTBY results, edit the formula, remove the column fields argument, and highlight the row fields argument, and let's select. But wait, we need our result to be region first and then the country name. But in our data, we have the opposite, and our row field argument requires us to select the rows in a sequence. Meaning, we can select multiple rows like this. If we edit our row fields argument, we can select just this one row, or we can select multiple, but it has to be in a sequence. No worries, we can do that as well. We did this with choose calls in our GROUPBY video. Let's do it with HSTACK this time. So let's edit our formula, specifically our row fields argument. HSTACK, array 1 is our region, array 2 is country, close brackets, and now this becomes our row fields argument, and that does it. Here we have our result the way we wanted them. That's done. Now let's move to the next argument, row total depth, which is subtotals and grand totals for the rows. So let's choose option number 2 from here. And we have our subtotals here and our grand totals here. Next up is row sort order. As of now, our first row is region, sorted in ascending order. Let's change it to descending. So we add minus 1 as our row sort order, and here we have our region in descending order. Next is column depth and column sort order, which performs same as for rows, depth and sort, and would work in result where we have columns. But we have skipped column fields in this example. Last is filter array, which is again similar to the filter box in our pivot table. Say if we just want to see the data from Europe, we will edit our formula like this. In our filter array argument, we select the region column and put equal to sign. Mention Europe in double quotes, and we have our data filtered only for European region. Similarly, if we want to exclude Europe from our results, we can change the equal to sign to less than and greater than signs, which means not equal to, and we have excluded Europe from our results. Now that we've completed all the arguments, let me show you a neat trick. How do you get this from your data? This has all the cities that come under the respective regions neatly mentioned in a tabular manner. You can't do that with pivot table, but you can do that with PIVOTBY. Let me show you. We're going to use array to text as our function for this, so let me make more space here and write our formula here. PIVOTBY, and we select region as our row fields, skip the column fields, and for value, we select our city names. For function, we select array to text and finish our formula. So we have all the cities and they are separated by a comma as well, which is a nice touch, but they're coming up multiple times, which is not what we wanted. So how do we get there? Remember, in the first part of this video, I said that these functions are eta reduced lambda. In a nutshell, Microsoft has included these lambda functions here to help us choose them. But we can replace them with our own lambda functions. For instance, if I am to write lambda x, comma, array to text, x and close all the brackets, I get the same result as before. All we need now is to make these values unique. It's fairly easy to do that though. Now we can use unique for that. So we go in our lambda and mention unique here. Just make sure to have enough closing brackets. We don't want an error now. And done. Now that's something cool that you can't get with your pivot table, can you? That's all about PIVOTBY, but there's a tiny little formula that is also a part of the Excel arsenal, which is pretty simple, and I think they've introduced it with GROUPBY and PIVOTBY and thought, why not let them use it separately as well? I'm talking about %of, which is present in the functions under both PIVOTBY and GROUPBY, though it's a simple formula, but I think it will be quite useful to you if you are in the finance sector. If we need to see how much this value is %of the total of this whole column, we can use %of like this. %of, select the first cell as data subset, and for data all, select the whole column and done. Let's convert it to percent from here, and here we have our result. This is not just limited to one column. If you wish to see a value in I2 against the whole data set, you can do so as well. Choose I2 as data subset and all of this as data all and done. And with that, we have completed everything we started out to. I hope you liked this video and would share it with your friends and coworkers. If you have any queries or feedback, get to the comment section, and while you are there, you will find a subscribe button somewhere close. If you haven't subscribed already, that is something you should really do. I publish new videos every Friday, and in case of anything exciting comes up, which can't wait till next Friday, it gets priority and I upload it on Tuesday. So until next time, happy spreadsheeting.